Let us continue with our topic of fast Fourier transform. In the fast Fourier transform, so far we have seen the two algorithms, decimation in time and decimation in frequency fast Fourier transform algorithms. We saw what is the basic difference between these two algorithms. It is the basic butterfly structure which is different in both of these algorithms. And decimation in time starts with a decimating of the time domain sequence. And decimation in frequency is such that the samples are decimated in the frequency domain. And one more thing we noted, that in case of decimation in time FFT algorithm, we provide the input in the bit reversed order, that is a decimated sequence, and we get the output in the normal order. But in case of DIF FFT, we give the input in the normal order, but we get the output in the bit reversed order. Now in this lecture, we will be seeing how to solve the 4-point DFT of a sequence when using this DIT and DIF algorithm. So here the value of n here in this numerical is 4. So previously we had solved the numericals wherein the value of n was equal to 8. So we had seen those numericals. Now we are going to use the same butterfly structure, but here the value of n is equal to 4. Okay, so when n is equal to 4, how many stages will be requiring? So this is the formula for computing the number of stages. So in this case, we'll require only 2 stages. So the numerical becomes very easy here. So the butterfly structure gets reduced. Okay, since the number of input signals are input is less. So now what we do now, the steps that we had seen. We have to give the input in the bit reversed order, since we are solving for DIT FFT algorithm. So our bit reversed order will be 0 to 1, 3. The normal order is 0, 1, 2, 3. But now if we decimate into even and odd, we will get 0, 2, 1 and 3. So these are our inputs, 4 inputs. Now we will be using the basic butterfly structure. Now so this is the basic butterfly structure for DIT FFT. So first we are having the twiddle factor, then we are having the minus 1 sign. So here we are having the twiddle factor, so here we should write the minus 1 sign. So in this diagram it is not shown, so everybody should draw this here. When you draw the diagram, here you have to show minus 1 sign. So this is our first butterfly. So what will be the, so this is the first butterfly. So similarly now, this is the second butterfly. So here you will write here minus 1 for this. And again here you will write minus 1 for this. Okay, so in this way we can have the 4 butterflies here. So first 2 butterfly and the combination of these 2 butterflies. So we will get the output here in the normal order. The input is in the bit reversed order, but the output is in the normal order. Next we require the twiddle factors. So we require only 2 twiddle factors. So these 2 twiddle factors we compute. So these twiddle factors are computed using Euler's identity. So we know that Wn nk is equal to e raised to minus j 2 pi nk divided by capital N. So capital N is 4 here. So this we compute. So we get this value as 1 by Euler's identity. Similarly, this we have used here Euler's identity. E raised to minus j theta is equal to cos theta minus j sin theta. So we get here minus 1. So in this way, we first draw the basic butterfly structure. Then while drawing the basic butterfly structure, we have to use the basic butterfly of the DIT FFT algorithm. So we have to see the twiddle factor is first, then there is minus 1 sign. So we have not to make that mistake. And we have to remember that these 2 twiddle factors will be requiring W40 and W41. Now after this, once you draw this, the next step is to calculation of the twiddle factors, computation of the twiddle factors. So only 2 twiddle factors are required. Now next we start with the computation now. So first computation is S10. So S10 is simply x of 0 plus x of 2 into W40. Since W40 is 1, so we'll get here x of 0 plus 1 into x2 of 0. So x of 0 is how much? So given x of 0 is 0. And how much is x of 2? So given x of 2 is 4. So 0 plus 4, we get the answer as 4. So the first answer here, S10, we will get it as 4. Similarly, now you can compute S11. So for computing S11, we have seen in the basic butterfly structure, it is A minus twiddle factor into B. So this will be A minus twiddle factor into B. So this is your A. So 0 minus twiddle factor into B. So 0 minus 4, so we'll get the answer as minus 4. So this is your second output S11. Similarly, now you can compute the third output S12. So this is S12, similarly we had computed, and this is S13. So get S13 here. So these are the four outputs that we get of the two butterflies. Now these outputs are combined. These outputs are serving as an input to the next stage. So first stage calculations are over. Now in the second stage, these will act as an input here. So this is our first butterfly. So S10 and S12 are the inputs, and X0 and X2 will be the outputs. So let us see how this is computed. So X0 is equal to, so X0. So in this case now, X0 is equal to S10. So here it is S10 plus S, what is this here? S12. So this is your output S12. So this butterfly we are considering. So S12 into the total factor. What is the total factor here? W40. Okay. So 4 plus 8, we will get the output as 12. Similarly, now X1. So X1 for the next butterfly it is. Let us see X2, the minus sign. So X2 will be what? S10 minus W40 into S12. Okay, because this is the basic butterfly structure. A minus total factor into B. So we get the third output, that is minus 4. Similarly, if you consider this butterfly now, this butterfly which I am circling. Now, if you consider this butterfly, this will be the two. One is the plus output, another is the minus output. So in this way, you get all the outputs here. So these are our final outputs. So this are our final outputs of the DFT. So hence we get the answer here in the normal order X(k). So whatever outputs we have got here, we just tabulate them here in the X(k) form. So this will give us the DFT of the 4-point sequence using DIT FFT algorithm. Now if you want to apply the same algorithm using DIF, what will be the changes? There will be minor changes. In this case also, here the number of stages will be 2. Same structure we are having, but see, remember the structure here. We started with the 2-point butterfly here, but here we are starting with the 4-point. It is reverse, and we are giving the input in the normal order. Okay, here we are giving the input in the bit reversed order. So 0, 2, 1, 3 we had given, but here we are going to give the output in the normal order. So here our input is in the normal order, but we are getting the output in the bit reversed order. So that is the case. So when you give the input in the normal order, you will get the output in the bit reverse order. When you give the input in the bit reverse order, you will get the output in the normal order. So this is the concept. Now this is our butterfly structure. Now the basic butterfly for DIF algorithm is this. So first output is A plus B. Second output is A minus B bracket into total factor. So where is the minus sign here now? Minus sign is before the total factor. So here you have to draw the minus sign. So this is our total factor. So here you will have the minus 1 sign. Here is our total factor. So here before this arrow you can write here minus 1. Similarly, before this total factor, here we will having minus 1. And before this total factor, here it is our minus 1. So this is our structure. So compute the total factor. Same total factors we require. Same calculations are again repeated. Now we will get the first output. So S10. So what will be S10? It will be simply X0 plus X2. So we get it 0 plus 4. What will be S11? Again, it will be X1 plus X3. So addition. But now what will be the output S12? So this will be X0 minus X2 into W40. So this is our third output. Similarly, we get the fourth output. Now whatever outputs we get here in the output of the first stage, that we are going to combine in these two stage butterflies. So simply the first output will be X0. The second output will be X2 here. X0 will get X2. So first plus and then minus. So same computation. And finally, we are getting this output. But this output is in the bit reversed order. So we have to place in the normal order. So this is our X0 first. Then we'll place here X1. Then we'll place X2 here. And then we will place X3. So this is our final output of DFT. So we have seen that we are getting the same output. So whatever output we got here, same output we got for DIF. So both algorithms will give us the same output, but their computation is different. So this you have to note while solving the numerical on 4-point DIT.